Greetings, 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 my brothers and my sisters. This is Brother Wes. I want to talk about a certain topic, and I'm just going to briefly talk about it, but it's something I want to probably expound on it even more, maybe tomorrow. I heard the question on Wiser that God's people don't like the fellowship. We don't come together. We don't support each other. And the title of my message today, to answer that, my title will be Pastors After God's Heart versus Pastors After Their Own Heart. The Bible says in Jeremiah 3:15, it says that He's going to give us pastors after His own heart that will feed His people with knowledge and understanding after His own heart. And so the problem, one of the reasons why churches or people, the people of God, are not unified is because of the heart. But also knowledge. See, because knowledge is information. And not every knowledge is good knowledge, because it was knowledge that caused the man to fall, the knowledge of good and evil information. And so it's dependent on the type of information, because there's some information that's forbidden. Adultery, that's information. It's forbidden. Forbidden fruit, things that God constitute as being sin or not, God spoke against. The carnal mind is an enmity against God. Anything that's formulated from flesh is against God. So it's information, and what type of information. But what I've noticed in ministry, if I could see pastors after after God's heart, one of the reasons why I think and I believe that some pastors now, they're very careful for people coming into their ministry or coming into their church to do revivals, is because of fear and the lack of trust. It's the lack of trust, because there are so many, and even some of those pastors, when they were younger in ministry, maybe they ran the evangelistical field as a prophet evangelist, and they may have done things that were not according to God, because there was many, back in the days, there were many prophets. There are many prophets that when they went to churches and went to churches with their gifts, what they would do, they would prophesy the house down, preach the house down. But they did two things. They took all the money and they raped the women, or they left the church in confusion. They left the church in an uproar. And after they left, then the pastor had to come clean it up. And so now many of those pastors, because they've experienced that, now they know what to look for, and they're just careful. If I can use an example briefly, is that just like a guy, natural guy, us as guys, when we grew up as guys, we think a certain way, and younger, you know, we like women. And so we do certain things to get women. But now we're men. Now we have daughters. Now we're afraid, because we know what young guys think and how they think. And so what they would do and what they would say to get the women, or to get inside the girls' panties or whatever, or underwear. And so now that's why pastors are like that, because they know the game. They know the hustle. There's a lot of hustling. And see, but and for that reason, there are some pastors, because they don't trust none of them, to an extent, they're careful. And what's happening is that they're not allowing the 5-4 ministry to get in their church. Because the Bible says that God, Jesus, sent down the 5-4 ministry gift for the perfecting of the saints, that we might go into the unity of the faith. And so the church is not maturing. That word perfection is maturity. The church is not maturing or growing because the 5-4 minister is not in the church, or is not at work, because they're not being invited in because of wickedness, because of sin, because of, you got many ministers that are greedy and that are selfish, and that they come for, they have an agenda, and that is to get money at any cost, not souls, but money. And let's flip this thing over. Now, there are some pastors that are not according to God's heart, but according to their own heart. There are some pastors, whether they're of God or not, they will use something. They will use a minister's or a preacher's ambition and their goal and desire to preach. They will use against them. And I had something like this happen to me once. And this is the game. These pastors, they will invite ministers in, and they want them to minister to the church. But what they would do, they want them to leave an offering, or leave a certain amount on offering. And when these ministers come in, they won't take care of their hotel expenses. And also, they will not guarantee that if they preach, that they will receive an offering. And so what they're doing, they're taking advantage of a lot of these ministers that
or have a zeal, not in the court of knowledge. And so that's where the confusion is at. And so also what's happening is that a lot of ministers that know this game, they don't even want to go to certain type of churches because they don't want to be used and taken advantage of. See now, there's not a price with God, with the gospel. But the Bible says that if any man deliver the gospel, they should get paid from the gospel. In other words, they should be paid. A laborer is worthy of his hire. And so it's just common sense and it's just protocol. This is like if you invite someone into your house, then you're going to take care of them. You invite somebody to come stay with you, you're going to take care of them. See, but it's a game. And see, it's the enemy that's crept in while men slept to put this thing in there where there's no trust. We don't trust each other. Because of the past, because of wickedness in the church. The devil has planted wickedness in people that has bad motives. And for this reason, everybody stand off. We don't trust nobody because the ministers and leaders don't want to be hustled on both sides. And so for that reason, what pastors will do, they will get other pastors who after God's own heart. And they will invite them in to teach and preach to their ministers or to their ministry or to their church. That's what they're doing. And they're not inviting the 5-4 ministry in. But we have to. That's why it's trust. See, God is looking at your heart. See, there are many churches that are trying to get rich and trying to get fat off of eager and exciting and zealous ministers. They'll take advantage of them. And in like manner, there are some pastors that are after God's heart, that they're feeding God's people with God, with his word. But then, because they made a mistake once or another, then where the ministers would come in, the preacher would come in, and the prophet would come in and take advantage of the people. So now they're raping the people. So now they're inviting nobody in. They're keeping everything in-house.